I still remember the date, 3rd November 2012. My wife Anjali and I went to see the movie, the latest movie of James Bond, Skyfall. I'm a huge fan of James Bond movies, but what I saw truly took me by surprise. There were so many changes in the movie. We exited the theater, and I booked for the next day, same movie, 6:30 p.m. I had to come back. I had to come back to see all the changes which I had seen on day one. And I was flabbergasted when I saw it on day two. We exited on day two, and again I wanted to book tickets for day three, same movie, 6:30 p.m. My wife refused, my kids refused, and I didn't go. With Skyfall, I am now going to tell you about the first strategy which I'm going to speak about, which is strategy of reinvention. Here are a few facts about James Bond. I'm sure there are Bond fans in the audience. Here are a few facts. The first movie of James Bond, Dr. No, was released in 1962. On the 50th anniversary of Bond movie in 2012, Skyfall was released. In the interim, there were other movies like Fast and Furious, Mission Impossible, Bourne Identity, which had lot and lot of stunts, special effects. Clearly, the Bond franchise had to be reinvented. It was doing well, but it had to be reinvented. And Skyfall did exactly that. I'll give you just two examples, glaring examples of the reinvention. The young Mr. Q, the quartermaster, hands over only two gadgets to James Bond, a gun and a radio. And then he looks up at James Bond and makes a snide remark. He says, "Were you expecting an exploding pen? We don't really go in for that anymore." Here's one more change. The theme of all old Bond movies was on the Cold War. Cold War was over, and Skyfall had a theme which is modern, contemporary, which is a theme of terrorism. The young Mr. Q, who is Ben Whishaw at the age of 31, is the youngest Mr. Q in Bond movies. And the pairing of Mr. Bond, James Bond, reminds us of what we see in many new companies. We have startups where you have young entrepreneurs who start these companies. They're young, they're energetic, they're probably more and more digitally savvy than any other person, but they require the help of mentors who will guide them through all the quagmire of business. Mentors help them to figure out how to do the business. This is how both of them come together. Skyfall was a huge success. It grossed $1 billion. And that proves that if Bond can be reinvented, so can you. You can also reinvent yourself. But reinvention does not mean throwing out the old. It can always be done with a good amalgam of the old and the new. From the contemporary character of James Bond, I now move and turn the pages back of history to a legend, Alexander the Great. At the young age of 20, he became a king in a very sudden manner. It wasn't planned, and he became a king. Over the next 12 years, he drove a long campaign, and by the age of 32, you heard me right, by 32, he had conquered the entire known world at that point of time. The most decisive battle of his entire 12-year campaign was the Battle of Gaugamela. In this battle, Alexander had 50,000 troops on his side, and on the other side was King Darius with twice the number of troops. And instead of going straight, Alexander went to his right, the battlefield. Darius thought that was a big mistake, and he sent his huge cavalry to chase Alexander. Alexander saw the thinning of the troops on the other side, and saw a gap. He quickly went into the gap because he had a agile army, light cavalry, light infantry. And by the time Darius realized that Alexander is moving in the gap, he could not stop him. Alexander came within a couple of feet of Darius. Darius fled from the battlefield, and Alexander won the war. Alexander won this Battle of Gaugamela because of sheer good strategy and military brilliance. He had a much smaller army, only 50,000 troops, and King Darius had double the size of the army, yet Alexander won because amazing strategy utilized. If you compare this to what's happening in the corporate world, a great example is what happened by Nirma Detergents. In 1969, Karsanbhai Patel, he was a government employee, and he started formulating a detergent in his house, in his bathroom, in a bucket. He called it Nirma after his daughter Nirupama. He priced it at 3.50 rupees a kilo as against Surf, which was by HLL, and which had a dominant market share, which was priced at 15 rupees. He found a gap in the dominant market share of a huge multinational, and he found a product which Indian consumers loved at a price point which Indian consumers loved, and the rest is history. Nirma has become a huge success. So he used the strategy of finding a gap in a large, large multinational. Alexander won many battles in 12 years of his campaign, long campaign, and all his battles he won was because of sheer great strategy and military intelligence and brilliance. All of us in business can learn a few things from Alexander and his strategy at war. From James Bond to Alexander, I now move to the fast-paced world of Formula One racing cars. What is it about 20 cars going around a circuit, zipping around a circuit for 90 minutes at 350 kilometers an hour at the deafening sound? If you hear or be at a Formula One racing for the first time, you'll wonder what's happening. But the epitome of teamwork and agility is a pit stop. Each car and each team has to come for a pit stop at least once during the race. A car has to do a pit stop. When it comes for a pit stop, all the four tires are removed, new tires are put, damaged parts are changed, wings are adjusted. There are 20 mechanics sitting on the car, and each of them knows precisely what he or she has to do. They practice and practice and practice. And can you imagine how much time it takes to remove old four tires, put new four tires, adjust the wings, remove some parts? Between 2 to 2.5 seconds. Yes, you heard me right. The average time is around 2 to 2.5 seconds. In fact, last year at a race, tires were changed in 1.89 seconds. This is the ultimate test of teamwork and synchronicity between the mechanics who are there. Coming back to business, if it takes 2 seconds, 2.5 seconds to change four tires, put new tires, why should it take 24 hours or even more to respond to an email, to take a decision? In that 24 hours which you take to take a decision, 130,000 tires would have been changed. So next time you sit on an email, remember, it takes just 2 seconds to change four tires, it should take around the same time for you to take a decision. If you have to learn teamwork, agility, speed of decision making, strategy, Formula One racing is the place to go and the place to watch. From James Bond to Alexander to Formula One racing, I finally come to Baba and the art of brand extension. As we sit in India, we are seeing an amazing commerce unfolding, the commerce being unfolded by Godmen and Godwomen. Godmen and Godwomen are turning entrepreneurs. The most famous of them are Baba Ramdev, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, and Jaggi Vasudev. So what is happening? The most visible story is of Baba Ramdev. Baba has a huge following over television, over all the gatherings he has. He and his close aide, Balkishan, started Patanjali Ayurveda to sell Ayurvedic products. Then he started selling hair oil, he started selling toothpaste, he started selling soaps, cookies, and also noodles. Amazing stuff. They have reached a turnover of 100 billion rupees, and they're expected to cross 200 billion in a couple of years' time. Baba is everywhere. He's on pictures on the bottles, on the advertisements. He endorses them. He says openly, these are my products. And it's a virtuous circle. The more the followers, the more the products get sold. Truly speaking, India is the largest laboratory in the world where Godmen and Godwomen are in commerce. And this is just the beginning. I believe they will now go overseas, which they've already done, And this is unstoppable in a true sense. But is it? Is there a downside to all of this? There is. And you heard the story of Ram Rahim, who was the founder of DSS in Haryana. They claimed at one point to have 50 million followers. They had launched products called MSG, similarly around 100 kind of products. And then Ram Rahim was convicted of a crime in August 2017, and is sitting in jail. And the sales of all his products nosedived. The identity of an individual is so closely associated with the brand that if anything happens to the individual, the brand collapses. So that's one big downside to Baba and the brand extension. But yes, all of us have to learn the art of brand extension from Baba Ramdev. So why Mouse in the House? Mouse in the House is an innocuous disruption. If you have a mouse in the house, what do? You attend to it or you ignore it. If you ignore it, it can become a disaster. Similarly, in all the businesses you run, remember, there is a mouse in your house. And what do? You have to find strategies from the strategy of reinvention of bond to the strategy of brand extension for Baba. There are strategies everywhere. You don't need abstract textbooks or abstract imagination to figure out a strategy which is right for you. It's all there in front of you. You have to just see it, learn it, and implement it. Thank you.